Stress relief meditation, how to reduce stress in your life. Dealing with anxieties, how to reduce stress and anxieties in your life. How to be more aware of what's happening in your life and be more calm, happy and healthy. Hi guys, my name is Lena Semenek and welcome to my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. I already spoke a lot about self-awareness and about thinking arrows, about how our brain works and how we get nervous and why we have so many worries, how to deal with fears on the psychological level, on the mental level. If you did not see those videos, all links will be below. And today I will show you the simple meditation technique, how you can use meditation and breathing exercises to reduce stress in your life. And it's very important to know all parts of the process, because in psychology we always talk about three components: body, mind and spirit. And body means that you feel relaxed in your body. When you feel relaxed in your body, your stress level will go down. Mind is when you know what's happening in your life, when you can analyze and understand why you act in a specific way, why, what do you feel if you feel angry or if you feel stressed or if you feel sad, you know what's the triggers, why those triggers are affecting your state. And the spirit basically, it's the way how you can work with your subconscious. And this is what I usually teach in private sessions and webinars. So if you would like to join me and meet me in person or online, just subscribe below. I will leave all my contact information. So today I will show you how to work with your body. And I will show you a simple meditation that will have three parts, and you can do this meditation any time of the day. You can do it at home. It's very recommended to find the quiet place where no one will distract you, disturb you. And it's very good to turn off your cell phone, maybe put it on the airplane mode, so no one will call, text you. And if during the meditation, and probably it will happen, you will feel uncomfortable sitting, lying down, you can change your pose, you can try different positions. Some people like to stand when they meditate, some people like to lay down on the bed when they meditate. So find what's gonna work for you, and it's okay to change your position during the practice. Not totally normal, don't think that it's not working or you fail, no. Just find the comfortable position for you. And if during the meditation you will notice that you start thinking about some problems at home, problems at work, don't feel bad, just get back to meditation, get back to your practice, and within time you will notice that thoughts, outside thoughts, are coming less and less, and you will be able to just move them aside and focus on your practice. So the meditation will have three parts, and the first part is when you focus on your breathing. You can just simply close your eyes or keep them open and breathe in a regular, most comfortable way for you. Just, you know, focus on your breathing, focus how you breathe in and how you breathe out, and focus on the feelings within your body. You might feel that you're not sitting straight, and at some point you want to maybe, you know, move your shoulders back. You might start focusing and hear some outside noise. Just, you know, get back to your practice, and simply within the 5 minutes try to focus on your breathing. And there is no any other instructions, just breathe the way you want. You can start breathing maybe deeper or shallow. Just focus and observe your breathing. That's why it's very important to put a timer on your cell phone for 5 minutes, so you know when the 5 minutes is up, because at the beginning it might look forever and it will be very hard to concentrate and to focus within yourself. So the first, breathe, just breathe simply and focus on what's happening within your body. The second part is to focus on what's happening in the room. So at this point, you focus on every sound in the room, on focus on the temperature of the air of the room, focus on what you can hear, and if it's silence, that's totally fine. Just observe the silence. Maybe you will hear how the other person is breathing if you're practicing with someone else. So just focus on everything what's happening around you. And again, if you start thinking about something else, some outside problems, that's fine, that's okay. Just, you know, get back to your practice. If at some point you feel like, you know, I want to change the cross of my legs, you can do it. And focus on the sounds that you're going to hear when you're going to change the cross of your legs. So focus on what's happening around you. And the third part of this meditation is to focus what's happening outside of your room. Maybe there is a car driving by, maybe there is a sound of nature, maybe there is a wind, maybe there is a rain, maybe there is some birds, maybe there is people talking, you know, in the next bedroom, or maybe there is a neighbor who is walking above you. So try to notice what's happening around you. Don't think why or like what's my neighbors are doing. If you, you know, catch yourself on thinking about why or how, just, you know, get back to your practice and just notice. The goal is just notice what's happening around you. Again, for 5 minutes. So the whole meditation will take about 15 minutes. And this is your practice. And you might experience some different feelings every time when you do it. And because at first you might feel tired, you might get angry, and you might think like, what's the crazy exercise? How you can even focus on your breathing? How you can even focus on your in your room? There is nothing happening outside, or like there's only silence, and you might feel angry. The second reaction is you might feel bad, you might feel sad, like I can't do it, I was trying, like, oh my God, it's only 2 minutes and I already changed my position 10 times. My neck hurts, my shoulders hurt. So, and you might feel bad about yourself, like you fail. The third reaction might be like, you know, I can do it, okay, let's do it, I can do it, I feel great. And then you might catch yourself that you're thinking about something else completely, not even about the problems or issues in your life, but maybe you catch yourself in some dreams. So that's also normal, that's also fine. And if you have any other different reaction, just write below. I will be happy to answer your questions and I will help you to understand why you're feeling that. So feel free to ask me any questions, and even if they feel crazy to you or you feel like something is not going on right, just, you know, ask me, share your feelings, share your comments, and I will be happy to read them. Let's talk a little bit about why this meditation is good. What's the benefits? Because in a lot of spiritual practice, people talk about the meditation, but they don't talk about benefits. And it's very hard to understand how and why you should sit for 15 minutes, you know, like meditating and thinking about nothing. First, to teach you to focus on your own feelings. So when you're in a real world, when you're dealing with problems, first you need to know what's happening with yourself. Because a lot of people, they get angry like this, or they get stressed like this, or they feel bad like this, or any other reactions, and they cannot notice the moment when it's starting. Because you actually, in reality, you don't get stressful like this, you don't get angry like this. Something happens and you notice it, and your body starts raising the stress level. And when you learn how to focus on yourself, how to focus on your breathing, on your feelings, on what's happening within your body, so you can notice in real life when what's the triggers. You will notice the triggers of stress, you will notice the moment when it's starting, So you will be more aware based on how you feel, how you breathe, how you sit, and you will notice, for example, maybe in a stressful situation, the first thing you do is you like tensing your body. Or maybe you are, you know, putting your arms into fist. Or maybe you just start breathing more rapidly. So you will be able to notice your own reactions. The second benefit of this meditation is to learn how to notice what's happening around you. So for example, you are at work, and when people start feeling angry, or maybe your boss is saying some rude words to you, or maybe your boss start questioning or raising his voice, this might be a trigger. This might be the trigger for your anxiety and for your stress. And it's very important to know what's happening at that moment. So this meditation will teach you how to notice sounds, how to notice temperature in the room, how to notice all other things, maybe some smells. And for example, you might not even realize, but let's say your boss, when he's getting angry, he likes to drink coffee. Maybe coffee helps him to kind of calm down. So the smell of coffee might be actually the trigger for your stress. So when you smell coffee around you, you might start thinking like, okay, he's in a bad mood, there's something gonna happen. And you might not even realize it. So this meditation, when you focus on the sounds, smells, temperature around you, the second part of this meditation, this is how you're gonna learn to notice and to be aware of the people, the situation around you. And the third benefit of this meditation is to learn how to focus and how to notice what's happening in the outside world. So for example, let's say that you want to make more money, you want to be more successful in life. So you might feel strong inside you. You might feel that, okay, this is a good time at my work. My boss is in a good mood. I can go and talk to him. But maybe outside, maybe your company is not doing that well, and maybe it's not the right time for your company. And if you go in this specific moment, if you're gonna delete the fact what's happening outside, you might not get the desired result. And opposite, if you notice that, okay, my company, you know, did good in last month, my boss is happy, I feel confident, I feel strong, so this is time for me to go and ask for promotion. So that's why it's very important to notice three components: what's happening inside you, what's happening in your close circle around you, in your home, in your workplace, and what's happening in the outside world. The fourth benefit of this meditation is you teaching yourself how to switch between different states. So at first you focus within yourself, you focus on your breathing, then you focus on what's happening in the room, and you're switching between yourself, your emotions, your feelings, you're switching to the situation around you, and you're also switching to what's happening outside of your room, outside of your house. So in this way, you're building your inner state, you're making yourself stronger, so you can switch easily between those three segments, and you can evaluate all three segments and find the best way for you how to deal with the situation, or the best way for you how to move forward and find the best solution to solve your problems. And the fifth benefit of this meditation is a very simple. You're gonna teach yourself how to calm down. And in order to calm down, we have to breathe. When you breathe in deeply, when you breathe out, you calm down. And the first 5 minutes is gonna teach you exactly this. You're gonna just sit, breathe normally, and focus on your breath. You're gonna learn how to move to the side your thoughts, how to move to the side your problems, how to move to the side your emotions and your feelings. And you're gonna learn how to distance yourself from whatever's happening in your world. And in reality, it's very important. When you are in a stressful situation, you need to step out of the situation, like to look at the situation from the side. And this way you will be able to distance yourself from the situation. You will be able to see what's happening with other people in this situation. You will be able to notice what's happening within you and find the best decision that works specifically for you. Okay, let's summarize. So, three components. First 5 minutes, you just sit and focus on your own breathing. What's happening within your body? Try to feel your body, feel the support under your body, feel your shoulders, feel your arms, your legs, and focus on your breathing. You can close your eyes, you can keep them open, but usually when you close, you can concentrate and focus more on your internal feelings. The second part, another 5 minutes, you focus on what's happening in the room. Sounds, what smells, temperature, and you just simply observing what's happening around you. If you are meditating with other people, you might hear how they breathe, you might hear how they move. Just observe. Don't try to find an answer why they're doing this, and if you do catch yourself on those thoughts, just get back to your practice. And the third part is to focus what's happening outside of the room. Maybe it's your neighbors, maybe it's people in the other room, maybe it's a car outside of your room. 5 minutes, try to focus on all the sounds, on everything that's happening outside of your room. Share your questions below. Don't be afraid to ask your questions. Share your comments. I will be glad to hear your opinion. Post this video on your Facebook, Twitter, share it with your friends, co-workers, spouses, help me to promote my channel, subscribe, click the bell icon to receive notification of new videos that I release every week. Ask your questions and remember that your question might be the topic of the next video. And of course, see you next time, and thank you for watching Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life.